higher education is navigating a wave of overlapping global challenges. From climate shifts to economic uncertainty, the pressures are reaching well beyond the campus. At the same time, institutions, educators, and students are tackling shifting learning expectations, changing demographics, workforce shakeups, and the ongoing debate about the value of higher education. This year's Teaching and Learning Horizon Report captures the spirit of transformation through the lens of emerging trends, key technologies, practices, and scenario-based foresight. If we want to shape the future of higher ed, we have to look beyond campus walls and pay attention to the social, technological, economic, environmental, and political trends. Higher education is deeply rooted in social context. It can be better understood by mapping the important social trends developing within and around it. Interest in designing inclusive learning environments continues. By engaging in inclusive practices, higher education institutions can achieve improvements in multiple areas. For instance, inclusive learning environments can boost student retention, success, and engagement by providing equitable access to learning resources and leveraging culturally responsive teaching. Implementing technology-enabled accessibility solutions, such as digital tools for neurodivergent learners and Indigenous language preservation, can help ensure equitable access for marginalized groups. Polycrises are on the rise. A polycrisis occurs when multiple crises, such as economic instability, climate change, public health emergencies, and geopolitical tensions, interact in ways that exacerbate their individual impacts. Within institutions, polycrises could impact stakeholder groups in profound and varied ways. Students may face disruptions in their learning and experience increased mental health challenges, with marginalized groups disproportionately affected. This would increase the pressure on institutions to provide more mental health resources, financial aid, and other forms of support. Moving forward, institutions must develop comprehensive crisis frameworks and secure funding to support crisis prevention and management. Technology is changing students' cognition. With technology reshaping student learning and engagement, institutions are under pressure to update curricula, redesign assessments, and push back against the drift away from critical thinking. Institutions may need to explore more modular, hybrid, and technology-rich teaching methods that engage students while maintaining academic rigor. They'll need to prioritize digital literacy and rethink assessments to move past traditional tests, focusing on creative and critical uses of technology. Institutions might explore project-based assessments or adaptive testing methods that leverage digital tools to provide personalized learning experiences while encouraging deeper cognitive engagement. With technology constantly changing, institutions need to regularly assess the tools they've already implemented and plan for new ones that foster better decision-making and more flexible teaching and learning. VR tools are becoming more advanced and affordable. Virtual reality technologies are becoming increasingly advanced and affordable, offering institutions new opportunities to enhance immersive learning experiences and accessibility. By integrating VR into curriculum design, institutions may be better able to align learning outcomes with industry needs, ensuring that graduates are ready for the workforce and equipped with the appropriate skills. Adopting VR tools could help institutions tackle ongoing challenges like accessibility, changing learning preferences, and the evolving demands of the workforce. Focus on democratization and efficiency in technology has increased. As progress is made in democratizing and streamlining higher ed, institutions stand to gain a variety of key benefits. Institutions will be better able to streamline operational processes, allowing them to reallocate resources to more desirable areas such as teaching and learning, as well as student support and services. To leverage new technologies, institutions will have to overcome hurdles like limited budgets, outdated systems, and gaps in digital literacy. They'll also need to prioritize equitable access for underserved groups while addressing growing data security and privacy risks. Technology is providing new ways to document student learning and success. Institutions are increasingly exploring innovative methods for documenting student achievements. Institutions aiming for a more comprehensive view of student learning might look into alternative documentation methods like digital badges, blockchain credentials, comprehensive learner records, and e-portfolios. To succeed, institutions will need to train faculty and staff, establish consistent documentation standards, and balance privacy concerns with resource constraints and expanded access to data. Economies and enrollment patterns fluctuate, so institutional leaders need to be prepared for fiscal instability and uncertainty by anticipating declines in funding and adopting new ways to think about and plan for institutional business. The potential for a trade war is increasing. As geopolitical tensions rise and economic policies shift, the chance of trade wars increase, bringing new risks and potential disruptions for higher education institutions. A trade war could exacerbate geopolitical tensions, which would defer international students from enrolling and reduce a critical revenue stream for many institutions. Immigration policies tied to trade disputes may also restrict the ability of international faculty to work in the United States or other affected countries. Additionally, setbacks to international academic partnerships such as study abroad and exchange programs could limit opportunities for cross-cultural learning and collaboration. The demand for some to return to office continues. Although many higher ed institutions continue to embrace remote and hybrid work and teaching and learning options, some are implementing return to office mandates requiring staff and faculty to transition back to being on campus. In-person interactions can enhance faculty-student engagement, fostering deeper connections and richer learning experiences, which are harder to achieve remotely. However, these mandates may pose equity challenges for individuals with caregiving responsibilities or disabilities, potentially worsening recruitment and retention issues. Concerns about deglobalization are growing. Although the likelihood of deglobalization remains uncertain, higher education institutions must consider its implications, such as a shift would bring significant challenges. To prepare for these challenges, institutions can create contingency plans to address potential disruptions in research, teaching, and student support, particularly for those affected by political or economic instability. In a future where climate stability and sustainability take center stage, higher ed won't be able to ignore the need for sustainable practices, something that's been overlooked for far too long in planning and decision-making. Governments are expanding clean energy subsidies. Governments worldwide are increasingly expanding clean energy subsidies to accelerate the transition to renewable energy sources and address climate change. Higher ed has a big opportunity to lead the way in research, teaching, and workforce development around green energy. Lithium reserves have the potential to pave the way for a green energy workforce. Lithium reserves are crucial for advancing green energy, given that they power batteries for electric vehicles and renewable energy storage systems. By aligning teaching, research, and industry collaboration, universities can position themselves as leaders in sustainable energy education and workforce development. Food insecurity is increasing globally. Global food insecurity is escalating, with 343 million people across 74 countries experiencing acute hunger, a 10% increase from last year. This is being driven by factors such as conflict, economic instability, and climate change, which disrupt food production and distribution. Students facing food insecurity often struggle with academic challenges, mental health issues, and social isolation, which can negatively impact performance, retention, and overall well-being. Financial strain may also reduce enrollment, particularly among low-income students, amplifying the need for campus food assistance programs such as food pantries, meal sharing initiatives, and financial aid adjustments. Higher education, for better or worse, is always entangled in and concerned with the political climate and events of the present moment. Classification of institutions continues to change. The Carnegie classification system for U.S. higher education is undergoing major changes to better capture institutional diversity. The 2025 update will broaden the focus beyond degree levels to include research program levels and other key factors, offering a more comprehensive framework and bringing major shifts to higher education. Moving forward, institutions will need to invest in data infrastructure to align with evolving metrics while making sure that their strategic plan balances these classification requirements with the institution's mission and values. Uncertainty over technology-related regulations in higher education is growing. In recent years, proposals have been made to enforce stricter regulations and requirements, including enhanced oversight of online program managers and distance education, and more rigorous accessibility standards. However, with the new administration in office, it is less likely that these regulations will be updated and enforced. Although these changes may increase administrative work and limit some technologies, they can also improve data security, reduce cyber risks, and create more inclusive learning environments. Regulations for AI are lacking or ineffective. The rapid rise of AI has outpaced the creation of strong regulatory frameworks, leading to a lack of oversight and growing concerns about ethics, bias, and the societal effects of these technologies. The lack of effective AI regulation could create inconsistencies in how AI is integrated into teaching and learning, resulting in both uncertainty for faculty and disparities in student experiences. Institutions must also create governance frameworks for improving AI tools, strengthening data privacy, and collaborate with industry to develop AI technologies for educational purposes. Advances in AI and virtual reality are changing the way students engage with content, how we understand cognition, and how learning is documented and valued. As political and regulatory forces reshape the landscape, higher ed is being challenged to redefine itself in a world where slow evolution is no longer an option. Explore the full 2025 EDUCAUSE Horizon Report, Teaching and Learning Edition.